issue is not really about being firm or being soft. These are techniques. What really matters is that you and your team are working together to fulfill the purpose that you have designed for yourself. That's what matters. When you and every member of your team feel a very high sense of responsibility, a sense of duty, and sense of commitment towards fulfilling the purpose that you have set for yourselves together as, you know, one entity, as one group, then that's where the focus should be. When everybody is self-committed, self-motivated, self-inspired, self-energized, self-led from within themselves to perform in their best possible way and contribute to the overall purpose and objective and strategy of the team, so that the entire team moves forward and creates success, then you don't need firmness. You need to celebrate, and you need to give respect, and you need to, you know, enjoy and reward and further encourage and commend and compliment such behavior. But when any of the team members or the team in general is lagging behind, has lost focus on doing what it has to do, it's a matter of responsibility and duty and commitment and ethics and professionalism, because they've already accepted to be part of the team, and they committed to the plan, and they committed to the strategy, and they have embraced the purpose. So they've already made promises to the rest of the team that they will perform their part, their role, to the absolute best of their abilities, so that they don't damage, you know, what others are doing, because all roles are linked together and we have to put all the pieces together so that it becomes a complete picture. You can't afford any pieces of the puzzle not to be absolutely, you know, perfect or close to perfection, because it will show and it will damage the entire picture. So when you have the team members having this commitment, they look at whatever they're doing with that commitment and that sort of sense of duty and ethical responsibility and professionalism, when they are that kind of person, then it's a joy to be in such a team. There will be challenges, of course, but there will be technical challenges that the team will come together and solve so that they can all move forward. But when there is a situation where some or any of the team members have, you know, are sort of not fulfilling their obligations, falling short on their promises, not delivering to the best of their abilities, not fulfilling their commitments to the team, failing their other team members by not delivering the best possible quality as they've committed to, then you have a problem, because these people are not just damaging themselves, and they are heavily and severely, but they're also damaging everybody else, especially those who are really doing their best. Now, why are these people damaging themselves? Because, I mean, imagine how you feel when you are not delivering your best, when you're not trying your best. Imagine what happens to your self-respect, self-appreciation, your self-confidence, how guilt will, you know, will eat you from within. It's horrible how other people will treat you, what it feels to lose other people's respect as compared to gaining people's respect and enjoying your own self-respect and self-confidence. So in that kind of situation, of course you need to be firm, especially if you're in charge of that team, or if you're exercising leadership, or damage is happening, or people are falling short on delivering on their promises and commitments. So you need to be firm, not rude, not obnoxious. I'm not talking about breaking any, you know, politeness or ethical, you know, boundaries. I'm not talking about that. But you have to be firm, I absolutely clear and blunt in setting the boundaries and reminding people of the expectations and the promises and the commitment that they have made, and what others are expecting from them, and how what they're doing is part of the, you know, is part of the whole journey of success, and without them, they're damaging the success of everybody else. So you definitely have to be firm. Now, there are techniques of being firm, because everybody, you know, people are different. But definitely you start by highlighting it to others. And if people, you know, let's say they needed support, you give them support. They need encouragement, they need it, you give them encouragement. They need some empathy, you give them empathy. They need some space, you give them space. But this cannot go on forever, because eventually it will stall the whole operation. You know, you can't build a puzzle when part of the puzzle is being, you know, efficiently and productively constructed and the other part remains, you know, empty. This cannot sustain. I mean, okay, some lagging can happen from time to time on condition that people compensate and catch up. But you can't build a puzzle half done. Everybody has to do their share, especially if it's a complicated puzzle and pieces are, you know, interdependent, like, you know, 20,000 pieces. Many people have to come together to fix it. Every person takes, you know, one side of the puzzle and then bring them all together. So you absolutely have to be firm. And if firmness and, you know, that comes after encouragement and empathy and support, you know, that did not work, then what do? You have to be surgical. You have to let them go. Now, I know for some people this might sound harsh, but what do? Do you suffer? Do you make everybody else suffer because of some people are lagging behind in spite of the encouragement and the support you gave them? You're in an operating room and, you know, like to have 10 people, including nurses, working on a patient. And some of them, one or two of the nurses, are not doing their job properly. So what do? You just tolerate that at the expense of the patient. You put the patient's, you know, life at risk because they're not, some people at the operating theater, they're not fulfilling their role. You tell them one or twice, or they're tired, you tell them, okay, take a rest for 10 minutes and then come back. But if you see you've tried everything and it's not working, then you don't need them. And in fact, if you tolerated them, then you're not doing your role. Because your role demands that you make sure that everybody works together and, you know, produces the best quality, deliver their promised contributions to the highest, you know, standards of professionalism, so that the entire team succeeds. Otherwise, if you don't do that, then you have failed everybody and you have failed yourself. And you have even failed the, you know, people who are not really performing well, because these people need a wake-up call. And maybe they're not the right people, you know, in the right team. Maybe you need to change them. Maybe they need to, you know, look at other aspects of their life, find other opportunities, reposition themselves in different places. Or if they're really lazy, then they have to live with their own destiny. But you can't let them pull you down and pull the rest of the team down. Your commitment is to deliver on what? On the promise that you collectively made so that you can achieve success. Use every possible, you know, professional, ethical, intelligent way of doing that. That's your commitment. If you're leading a team or if you're managing a team. And if that includes being rough and tough with people who are not delivering, then you do your duty. That's why leadership is hard. That's why management is hard. Of course, leadership and management are different things, but in some cases, you know, they converge together. Why? Because it's about taking hard decisions, making difficult choices that people usually don't want to do. But it's your job to do that, and you have to. Otherwise, you're failing, and you become like others. You're not doing your job properly. And I know you don't want to do that. Exercise leadership, take the hard decisions, create success.